Good morning, students. Today we will be studying the topic chemical bonding. You have studied in the previous assessment about atomic structure and periodic table. These two chapters form the basis of chemical bonding here. In the chapter atomic structure, we have studied that atom is the smallest particle which can further be divided into electron, proton and neutron, right? And according to Dalton's theory, Dalton said that atom cannot be divided into further parts. But with the modern atomic theory, it was proved that atom can be divided into various parts as electrons, protons and neutrons. Also, atom is the smallest part which takes part in the chemical reaction. So now we know that atom is the smallest particle which takes part in the chemical reaction. And second point, it takes part in chemical reaction. Means atoms have independent existence, but atoms have independent existence, but they stabilize themselves by combining and forming a molecule. So atoms, they combine and what do they form on combination? They form molecules. Okay, say two hydrogen atoms combine and they form a H2 molecule, or say two oxygen atoms combine and they form a O2 molecule. It is not necessary that the same atoms combine and form the molecule. It could be a combination of different atoms also. For example, say an atom of sodium combine with Cl and forms an NaCl molecule. Okay, so all these examples, we are seeing that atoms, they are combining and they are forming the molecule. So when they are combining and then they are forming the molecules, they are restricted by certain rules. It is not that any which way the atom can combine and form a molecule. Those rules through which the atoms would combine and form a molecule is something which we are going to study in the chapter chemical bonding. Okay. So chemical bonding means a bonding. A bonding is nothing but a linkage. So first we look into the concept of what does the word bonding means. Bonding, you can say, is a linkage, a force, you can say an attractive force, or you can say a joint or a connection. Okay, between what? Between atoms. What's the reason? So that they form the molecule. Why it is so? So that they attain stability. That's the nature's rule. Everything in the world wants to attain stability. So atoms, they combine, they form molecule in order to attain the stability. Now, what are the modes of various combination? How do the atoms combine? Okay, so bonding is a linkage, attractive force, a joint, a connection between the atoms so that they form the molecules to attain stability, so that they exist as a stable molecule. Now, what are the various types of bonding or what are the various types of linkages that exist? So first we'll look into what are the various types of bondings. Basically, bondings are of two types, electrovalent concentrate, we have two types of bonding, that is electrovalent and covalent. In 10th standard when you go, you will study a special type of covalent bonding called as coordinate covalent bond. So students, in this year we are going to study electrovalent bonding and covalent bonding. These are the two main type of linkages which we are going to study in this year. What is electrovalent bonding and what is covalent bonding? A basic idea of this you have already studied in your 8th grade. Okay, what is a electrovalent bonding and what is a covalent bond? Now, electrovalent bond is a bond which is formed by transfer of electrons. And covalent bond is a bond which is formed by sharing of electrons. In the chapter atomic structure, we have studied that atom, they can be subdivided into the subatomic particles, one of which is electron. An electron is the essential subatomic particle which takes part in the chemical reaction. Never in a chemical reaction you will find that the nucleus is taking part. They are the special reaction called as nuclear reactions, where nucleus takes part in the reaction. So mostly the electron is the subatomic particle which takes part in the chemical reaction. Either the electron is lost, or the electron is gained, or the electron is shared. So these are the three basic modes by which a chemical bond is formed. Now when we say transfer of electron, let's consider bonding with the friendship. You all have got friends around you. You all have got good friends, bad friends, and some friends which you like to spend more time with. Okay, so there are certain criteria. You decide your friend, right? Suppose a friend which is very good to you. Why do you call that friend as a very good friend of yours? Probably that friend is sharing everything with you, right? And a friend which is not sharing anything with you. So we can say that we can connect the bonding with the types of friends you have around. Now suppose one type of you are a person here and you want to have bonding with various types of people, right? The types of people you are trying to make bond with are, say, very good. You can say the noble gases here we consider. Say metals, different types of atoms, and say non-metals. Okay, this is all categorizing your friends. Okay, noble gases, say, are the type of friends which are very reserved kind of, they do not want to make bond easily because they are very, very good, right? So each one of you aspire them. You want to become as good as your very good friends, say, noble gases. So every atom tend to attain the properties of noble gases. Their tendency is to behave like noble gases. But they are actually metals. They are actually non-metals. But what is the problem? If they are metals, they have plenty of electrons, right? They have very large number of electrons in their valence shells. And when they are non-metals, they are short of electrons. So being a metal, they can always lose electron in order to form the bond. Being a non-metal, they can always gain electron to form a bond. So, and both metals and non-metals, they want to behave, they want to acquire the configuration of noble gases. So each type of bonding basically is in order to acquire the configuration of noble gases. That is, you want to become like a very good friend who is of yours, who is excellent in everything, right? So your tendency is to become like that or acquire those qualities of a very good friend of yours. So now here we start with, say, metals, they tend to behave like noble gases. Non-metals, they tend to behave like noble gases. So this results into various types of bonding. Now, when the transfer of electrons should happen in order to form a bond, the bond would be between one which is having lot of electron and another one which is having shortage of electron. So always a bond between a metal and a non-metal. Since I've already told you, metals they have plenty of electrons and non-metals they have shortage of electron. So a bond between a metal and non-metal is will be formed by the transfer of electron. So this type of bond will be called as electrovalent bond. The bond which is formed by transfer of electron, and obviously the transfer of electron will happen in the case when one has excess of electron and other has shortage of electrons. So when the electrons are transferred from a metallic atom to a non-metallic atom, the type of bonding which results into is a electrovalent bond. Now we come to the type of bond which is covalent bond. Covalent bond is the type of bond which is formed between a non-metallic atom and another non-metallic atom. Both are non-metallic. So both have the problem. What is the problem? Both are having the shortage of electron. So the bond formed between them, now they cannot lose, they cannot gain electron. Both are shortage of electron. So what do they do? They will share the electrons mutually. Okay. Suppose you have got one chocolate and you have got a very good friend of yours. So what you will do? You will give